Hi guys, this is Hobby Crochet, and today I want to show you how to make flamingo hat. It bends his head nicely. It is sits on a hat. I did not do the six stitches, you know, around like on a neck. I did little bit different. If you want to follow my pattern to make it like this, I can show you. Or if you don't like this, you can have six stitches and go around. But for me, doing six stitches all around is quite boring and it's quite tough. So I will show you how I did this strap first, and then we will make flamingo. This is basically, they call it Romanian cord. I will start with chain two, and then what you do, you just make a single crochet on one side, then you turn it and make a single crochet onto the other side. Then you turn and make single crochet on the side, basically picking those ridges. I'm not sure either to pick one or two, don't think it matters much, but you may always try it both ways, the way it's easier for you. As I always say, it's not a rocket science, it's just a little toy. So this time I will pick two of those ridges. I think if I pick one ridge, yeah, it will look nicer. But it's totally up to you, as I say. And this is basic cord that I will make long enough to go around the head. Then I will try it around the head. I will not tell you amount of rows I made, because everyone's got different amigurumis. So this is something like that. And now we will connect those ends. Take this stitch through the other side and connect them together. With slip stitch or with single crochet, you can even cut the yarn and stitch it with the needle afterwards. If you don't like this way I'm doing headband, you can always put six single crochets in a amigurumi circle and go around with six single crochets. I will leave the tail a little bit longer. It will be easier to hide it afterwards. This first part is done. Now let's do flamingo. Flamingo, I will start with amigurumi circle, magic circle, six single crochets, one, two, three, example, 5 and 6. Pull it. Row 2. Increase in every stitch to have 12 single crochets. First stitch I pulled very tight, but I will try to make 2 here and 2 single crochets in every stitch. And this is what I'm doing next. Want to pull this tight and cut it. I will separate this circle in two. One part will go to the head and another part will go for the neck. So let's count stitches. It should be 12. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Yes, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I want to leave one. If I count backwards from the stitch on my hook, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, into the seventh stitch I'm making single crochet all around. 1, 2, 3. 2 single crochet into the fourth. One, two. And then 3 single crochets next row, 3 single crochets, and then decrease. I will decrease those 2 I added. And 3 single crochets. Let's change the yarn into next stitch. Like this. And now I will add white. Pull, pull, pull. So little trick how to make this step invisible. Instead of single crochet, first you do slip stitch and then going around with single crochets in white. In every stitch. And once again, and next stitch I will change it for black, but I want to cut this yarn and make a knot, make a double knot. It will be inside, and I will take this through. I don't need those ends anymore. Okay, stuck somewhere, never mind. So now for the black, and I wanted to change it for black over this stitch. Slip stitch for the next stitch. Pull both yarns, and I think here I can already start making decrease. Let's cut white. One single crochet and decrease. Then again, one single crochet. Before decrease, I want to put away those ends. I will do exactly the same. I will make a knot. And take it inside. Just like that. Lost black. So now decrease and so I will continue making the row of decrease. Whenever you've got very little amount of very small amount of stitches over here, so basically I skipped one stitch and I will make, if I can, a stitch into the next, or maybe into two next. You see, it's like single crochet, basically it's nothing over there left. You just make it go to nothing. Make it into basically a big. That's all. Looks good. I can leave this end longer And then I filled it through and make eyes over there on the side. But first let's do the neck. Neck is easier. You just pick those stitches and go around. Isn't it cool? You can always give me a thumbs up if you like my videos. It could be really, really very good. It doesn't really cost you much, nothing basically, but it means a lot to me. With lots of those ends. Basically, I don't need those ends, I may just cut it. It will be out of my way. Or just put them inside. It will work as stuffing for the head a little bit. And it will be out of my way. Like this, look, it's cool. And now you are picking the stitches around as you go. As many stitches you've got, as this will be the thickness of the neck. Maybe I've picked the stitch here, but I will skip the stitch over there because it's very small. It will be just absolutely fine. And the way I started making this flamingo, it will shape the neck. So basically I should have around 6 stitches, because if it's less amount, it will be hard for me to go around. Yeah, I should have at least 6 stitches. And with all this, I will go around for a few rows. With the end you left from the beak, you can make eyes. Just a simple little bit of lines. From one side and feed it through the other side. And then I will take it down. Be careful over there, that black one, you put it right in the middle. And with this end, I will attach it to the headband. This amount, the way you did the neck, you can do this headband. It is entirely up to you. Once you attach this one, you will have your own flamingo head. Thank you. Thank you for watching. Hope you enjoy my tutorial. Give me a thumbs up. Subscribe to my channel.